What is Anna Hazare's plan? Why is he dissolved Team Anna? Is the movement going to become stronger? Is it going to become weaker now? There are so many unanswered questions. We have with us Dr. Devinder Sharma, member of the former Team Anna. Arun Bhatia, president of the People's Guardian Party. He's a strong supporter of Anna Hazare. Neeja Chaudhary, political analyst. Vijay Darda, Rajya Sabha MP of the Congress. Dr. Sambit Patra, spokesperson of the Delhi BJP. Amarjeet Kaur, National Secretary of the CPI, and Dr. Ajay Kumar, Lok Sabha MP of the JVM. Let's bring in Dr. Patra. You know, after Anna Hazare, the key member of the team is Arvind Kejriwal. But clearly, from what we're hearing, there's a growing divide between them. I mean, you know, there's several other questions that arrive. Why did Arvind Kejriwal make the political announcement first instead of Anna Hazare? Why was it that when Anna Hazare was telling his team not to attack the media, Arvind still went ahead and attacked editors after that? You know? Arvind attacked Pranab Mukherjee also, but Anna did not, you know?
See, in fact, it is totally the prerogative of Team Anna and Anna as to what decisions they take. We can only comment upon as observers. And what I feel that Anna is not a personality who can be drawn anywhere. He can always call the shots because he's the hero of the whole show. And it goes unsaid and undoubtedly. There's no doubt in it. So I believe whatever is cooking underneath is for them to answer in the best possible manner. But as far as BJP and we are concerned, we welcome anyone and everyone.
Are you concerned, by the way? Because people say if they enter politics, they might come cast some of your party's votes.
Even if they eat into our votes, no problems, because BJP stands committed to fight against corruption, to fight against nepotism and misgovernance that is going on in the present form of Indian governance.
Dr. Ajay Kumar.
A quick point, and the point is it not, it's from a question in fact, is it not that we are overreacting to their political formation or aspirations? Just wait and watch. I think time would be the best factor to judge whether their movement had strength or not. If their movement and public were really that, I mean, they really had that strength, then I think, as Mr. Bhatia says, they would get the requisite number of seats.
The question they're going to face is, all successful political parties have a target audience. Your party, Brahmins, Baniyas, middle class, the BSP, Dalits, the SP, Yadavs, Muslims, the left parties, the labour class. What is going to be the target audience of Anna's political alternative?
As I told, it's for the time to answer. And in fact, this confusion can only be done away with time. So let's wait and watch if at all they have an audience or not. Turning up in Ramlila Maidan or at Jantar Mantar is a different issue. And participating in a political scenario is totally different. So I think wait and watch is the best policy that we all should adopt.
All right. We've got...
Only one thing I would like to say.